Hello everyone, it's Sincere Journey, so you know I keep it real. We're here at Park Lakes Elementary School and we have a very important interview with an educational professional that's been teaching for over 22 years. So everyone, follow me. Oh, and you know we have our mask on because safety's first. Hello everyone, my name is Journey Green. Today I have a very special guest. I have Renetta Green. Can you please give us a little bit of background about yourself?
Hello, my name is Renetta Green. I'm a teacher at Park Lakes Elementary. I have been teaching for 22 years. I received my bachelor's degree in interdisciplinary studies, specializing in early childhood education from Prairie View A&M University. I later received my master's degree from Texas Southern University, specializing in education administration.
You said you've been teaching for 22 years. So how would you say the world has kind of adjusted from when you first began teaching?
Well, I would say that the world now is more technology. Mm-hmm. Technology is a big thing now. You know, the kids are able to do a lot of things on a computer. They actually can work it better than I can. So the technology has been a big change for me.
What have you taught over your education experience, and what do you currently teach?
Right now, I'm currently a special ed interventionist. I have taught pre-K and kindergarten.
What is your favorite thing about teaching?
Building relationships with my students and parents and seeing the growth at the end of the year. Once you build those relationships, the students will do whatever you need them to do. They'll learn what you need them to learn. The parents will work with you. Y'all will work as partners.
How have you adjusted to being an educator during a worldwide pandemic?
During the pandemic has really been a challenge, but rewarding at the same time. During the pandemic, we had to do virtual and in-class learning at the same time, so I felt like a brand new teacher. But it was rewarding because the parents actually got to know and got to see what the students were doing in class. That was really a benefit.
Okay, so can you tell me, was there a decrease in learning, would you say, when the students got back to school?
Most definitely, I did. I saw not so much with the kids in class, but the kids that was online, because being a parent, you want to help your kids, you want to make sure that they get it right, so you try to do the work for them. So it was a decrease in learning because when the kids transitioned and came back to school, we can tell that the parents was mostly doing the work for the kids.
What safety protocols have you implemented in your classroom?
At each table, the students, I had hand sanitizer. They also had to social distance, like 6 feet apart. We're lining up. We had to line up 6 feet apart. During lunchtime, they had to sit like every other seat. We also had hand sanitizer as they go inside of the cafeteria.
How important would you say representation is in the education field for students to see other people that look like them?
I think it's good. Everyone wants to feel like they belong. So to see different representation of themselves, I think is very important.
How do you feel about the no mask mandate that was recently put into place by our governor?
The no mask mandate really frightened me a little bit because I have a mom that's elderly and has health conditions. So with students not wearing a mask or teachers not wearing a mask, I felt like I didn't want to put her life in danger. So it's really scary for me.
Thank you for coming. It's been a real pleasure interviewing you. My name is Journey Green, and this has been Education in a Pandemic.